Sources say that Prime Minister Narendra Modi will be vaccinated in the second phase of the COVID inoculation drive launched last week. All chief ministers, MPs and MLAs above 50 will also receive vaccines. The drive was launched on January 16th with the healthcare workers and others at the front line of the coronavirus fight receiving jabs of two vaccines, Serum Institute of India's COVID-Shield and Bharat Biotech's Covaxin. Web series Mirzapur is now in trouble over allegations of maligning the image of Uttar Pradesh in the middle of controversy over another show, Tandav. The Supreme Court has issued notice to the makers of the series and Amazon Prime Video on a petition by a resident of Mirzapur in UP. The petitioner complained that Mirzapur has been portrayed in a bad light in the web series, now in its second season. The Bombay High Court today dismissed an appeal and an interim application filed by Bollywood actor Sonu Sood against a BMC notice over alleged illegal construction carried out by him at his residential building in Juhu area of Mumbai. While dismissing the actor's appeal and application, the judge said, "Law helps only those who are diligent." Sood's lawyer sought a time of 10 weeks to comply with the notice issued by BMC in October last year and requested the High Court to direct the civic body to not initiate demolition action. Members of the triumphant Indian cricket team, including stand-in skipper Ajinkya Rahane and coach Ravi Shastri, returned to the country on Thursday after the momentous Test series victory over Australia. Rahane, Shastri, star batsman Rohit Sharma, pacer Shardul Thakur and opener Prithvi Shaw landed in Mumbai, while Brisbane Test hero Rishabh Pant arrived in Delhi this morning. Democrat Joe Biden was sworn in as the President of the United States on Wednesday. His deputy, Kamala Harris, made history as she became the first woman, first Asian American and first colored person to be the Vice President of the country. Soon after taking charge, Biden signed a blizzard of executive orders on the coronavirus, immigration and climate change, launching a 10-day cascade of directives, reversing the policies of his GOP predecessors as Democrats push for even more sweeping and prompt legislative action.